don't really understand how I ended up here.
She captivated the world.
I'm losing sight of myself in the process.
In life and in death. Princess Diana's final days and the 1997 car crash that claimed her life have now been recreated in The Crown's last season.
I couldn't have done it without Khaled, who plays Dodi. I think the two of us just held each other through that.
So we took great care, and it was rather, you know, it was a bit nerve-wracking, but I hope we've got that right.
Not everyone thinks they got it right. In a one-star review, The Guardian calls the Diana-obsessed series the very definition of bad writing. So bad, it's basically an out-of-body experience. Other reviews call it uneasy, awkward, a creative dead end. And the ghost Diana scenes in which she appears after her death aren't received well.
What happened in private, we have no accounts for because they were very private moments. So they have to take liberties in terms of how did Charles break the news to William and Harry? We don't know what the Queen was like in those moments.
The makers of The Crown have always been clear the show draws from reality, but is not a documentary.
The history of every episode is meticulously researched, and then Peter dramatizes it, but it is meticulously based on reality.
I was never concerned that it wasn't going to be treated with the respect it deserves.
Only 4 episodes out of 10 have been released so far.
This is going to be the biggest thing that any of us has ever seen.
Te Aniwa Hurihanga Nui, One News.